Our next inductee was one of those fighters that it was really hard to ever root against him. Even if you were the best friend of his opponent, he's such a nice guy. Well, outside the ring, he's a very nice guy. Inside the ring, this guy was a monster, enough to win multiple titles and become one of the best fighters of his era. He was born on January 2nd, 1969, in Clarendon, Jamaica. He didn't start boxing until he was 20, with a late start in the amateur ranks. He did well, compiled a record of 35-5 with two Florida Golden Gloves championships. In his first 4 years as a professional, he ran off 32 straight wins and was rewarded with a title shot against then middleweight champion Bernard Hopkins. Hopkins would win in the 11th round. For the next few years, his career would be up and down, but when 2004 came around, it changed his life forever. He started by winning the light heavyweight championship in a battle against Clinton Woods. Then came a 9th round knockout of former world champion Roy Jones Jr. And he would earn a decision victory over fellow Florida Boxing Hall of Fame inductee Antonio Tarver. At that point, the boxing world started taking him very seriously. He lost a rematch to Antonio in 2005, but continued fighting on and winning several titles. He was nicknamed the Road Warrior. It was well earned, especially in the latter half of his career. He never backed down in going to an opponent's hometown, even overseas. For going to those hometowns, he would often lose close and controversial decisions. But the fans knew, they always knew, who the real winner was. He stepped out of boxing in 2015 with a final record of 54 wins, 21 losses, 2 draws, 37 wins by knockout. He fought 31 times in the state of Florida. Among his many accolades, named Fighter of the Year in 2004 by Ring Magazine and the Boxing Writer Association of America. He's kept busy in boxing since his retirement. He's been a trainer. I personally have had the pleasure of working alongside him doing some TV boxing commentary. We had a blast. Now he started his own boxing promotions company, Road Warrior Promotions. In the ring, his pressure style always made for entertaining bouts. Outside the ring, gracious and dignified. Everything you would expect out of a multiple world champion. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming to the Florida Boxing Hall of Fame class of 2021, former 3-time light heavyweight champion of the world, Glenn the Road Warrior Johnson.
Much of a talker, so I'm going to keep it short. I just want to thank, obviously, the Florida Boxing Hall of Fame. I want to thank my manager, Henry Foster. I want to thank Antonio Tarver. He's a man that put up a great fight and allowed me to show my skills. Roy Jones. I want to thank my trainer over there. Orlando Cuellar, and thank you guys for being here. I greatly appreciate it. See you guys next time. Thank you.